I think all I remember that Richmond, wasn't it?
24 is in victory lane, while the 24 brings out the caution here.
Uh-oh, what happened?
I don't see anything.
Pizza, pizza.
What happened? Whoa, now.
Very, very seldom do you spin out here and not hit anything, but I believe Chase Elliott just did it.
You just don't get away with that.
Caution flag for Chase Elliott with 23 minutes to go in cup practice. Joey Logano fought the wall at Bristol, and yeah, you guessed
we
it.
Know what,
the
won.
Wall won. Let's look and listen.
Just the right front, it looks like. I got the whole thing. The track's so dirty, it's like a tire pod when I got in the gray. I didn't even get in the gray. I was up one lane.
So, and here's the replay.
Yeah, it looks like Danica Patrick's coming onto the racetrack or was slowed down, and so the 22 came with some momentum, was going to go to the outside. And we talked about the marbles being up above that rubber traction strip or grip strip that we talked about, and he just went up there and lost control. So that tells you how little grip outside the groove there really is
on his car. But I don't think trouble turn two. Ricky Stenhouse backed it into the wall.
Whoa, buddy.
Caution. I was saying,
the right rear pretty good.
I don't think I've ever seen a young driver as composed for his age as Erik Jones.
I agree.
Ever.
He's an old soul. I mean, he's been doing this his whole life.
That's right.
Let's go for a ride with Ricky Stenhouse. See what happens down here in turn one. Goes down to the bottom. The back end just steps out.
Whoa. Pretty good leg.
Clear down.
I mean, he did a really nice.
Clear down.
Really nice job of that car not coming all the way around. The banking sort of picked it up. He did a little dirt track in there, and unfortunately still got the right rear corner of the rear bumper in the wall. And to me, that's what you're dealing with at this racetrack in general, DW, and you know over the years of what it takes to go fast as far as what the car needs to do.
And give it a try for a while. Let Jimmy know that Kyle was about 15. And that's exactly what they were wanting to avoid.
Lock it down. All right, hold it here. Don't move. Still got guys coming.
And that's the downside of what he's doing.
And there's the end of anybody running the top.
Well, you know what happened? He was picking up time. He was already up to a 15.6.
Yeah, he was gaining.
And in that time, he drove in a little high and got a little bit too much of that loose stuff. Yeah, got into marbles.
There's just not enough cars up there running that groove with him. He did a pretty nice job. He just kissed it.
Watch it, that masterful job. Working the brake, working the gas. Keep that car off.
You know,
the
wall. He just won a sprint car race on the off week.
He needed a wing on that baby to plant it. He said he had the wing in the trunk.
He goes in with his right sides on some of the rubber that's laid down. But before he gets to mid-corner, he is up in the marbles.
Yeah, he just got in a little high. It's just not any grip at all up where he was that time. See all the debris flying around.
He just kissed the wall.
He had just run the fastest lap.
He might have scraped it.
He had just run his fastest lap in this run. The lap before.
Well, we talked about Stenhouse wanting to fix that car, not to give up track position. That's your pole sitter right there because of being the points leader. So I promise you they'll fix that 42 car.
I'm starting to see some of the big guns make their way toward pit
road. Oh, Joey Gase, keep it off the wall. Oh, he does. Nice job of letting off the brakes, letting the car swing around to the inside.
Hang on there, bud.
Well, it's too late to hang on now. He's just got to get going again. But that was a nice job of driving after he lost control, not to get into the outside wall. Yesterday, Joey was 34th quickest at a 16.23, right down in the center of the corner. Maybe just a little high on exit, Larry, up out of that dark traction compound that's on the bottom of the racetrack, and around she went. You can see just right there, maybe a little bit higher than he wanted to be.
Yeah, we saw this actually in cup practice. If you tried to run the bottom and then you got up out of the groove whatsoever, it's called marbles. It's the rubber coming off the tires that goes above that grip strip. And Kevin Harvick put it like this. It's like you have ball bearings under your tires.
Race fans, it's time for the most famous words in motorsports. Here to give the command to fire the engines, please welcome our Grand Marshals, the daughters of Tommy Fitzgerald Sr. Please welcome Tiffany and Lisa Fitzgerald.
Drivers, start your engine.
On the pole, second of his career. Outside of him, Austin Dillon. Who's going to get the dash for cash? So many questions to be answered. We're green at Bristol.
Well, we answered one of them. Austin Dillon went to the top and took the lead away from Kyle Larson on the start.
Eric Jones won this race last year in the 20, settles in third. Behind him, the rookie Cole Custer in the double zero.
Well, I think that answers our question of what's going to happen with the top groove. I think it's just going to get better and better as we run through the day. But I think as you run through the race, I think the bottom is going to be the place to be for the beginning of the run.
Ryan Reed also started at the back. Here's the 16, a lap down, and he had a moment.
Well, it's a fine line up there. Like you see Kyle Larson making really good ground, but if you creep up a couple inches too high, those crumbs and those marbles, they're like ball bearings underneath the tires, and that car will just step out from underneath you because there's a lack of grip.
And another at lap 170, 85 laps later.
And we have problems here at the end of our opening stage.
I'll get you down here, just hold. And Larry, we'll be looking for that 33.
Larry McReynolds was talking strategy. I think we're getting ready to see some, because these racers that aren't going for stage points or stage wins will pit here. And I think a lot of the other guys will probably stay out and try to get those points. What do you see, Kevin?
Well, you saw what it did to Ryan Blaney last week when he didn't pit, stayed out for the stage points, and then wound up at the back of the field. So I think you have to pit in order to keep up with everybody to not lose all your track position.
There goes his tire, and Larry, I'm wondering, five laps, going to be four laps to go here in the stage. We're going to close pit road with two to go. Is it possible that we don't get pit road open? What do you think? I'm looking for the light. What happened to Ryan Reed? Bringing out our first caution of the day.
Well, I'll tell you what usually happens here is the right front tire blows because the tire gets too hot, because you don't anticipate all the brake heat that you wind up, especially when you have a car look like Ryan's car wasn't handling well. It melts the bead and the tire blows out.
And we also saw him scrape along that outside wall off turn two, so maybe some damage there, but definitely an ill handling car and lost his right front tire entering turn one.
One outside.
I think he was okay when he hit it the first time. Then he kind of went back for more, and they had to put the yellow out.
Well, what happens is you get up there and you get those 2 or 3 inches too high that I was talking about earlier, and those crumbs pile up against the wall, and they get on the tire, and then you can't get it down, and it just gets worse.
And that would be the second and final position out of stage two for the Dash for Cash. That could be a big battle with 17 laps remaining. And if we get to the end of the stage,
Bubba's really being aggressive on the back of Brennan Poole.
Don't wreck it. Keep rolling.
It doesn't get any more aggressive than that.
No, that's been going on.
Bottom three. Bottom two with him in the middle. Keep rolling.
That's the free pass position.
All good.
Big move there by Darrell Wallace Jr.
Well, that explains a lot of the aggression, because unfortunately, that's what you have to do sometimes. Unfortunately for us, because we get to watch it.
That was as aggressive as you'll see without wrecking somebody. And look, the hole was open. William Byard knew he needed to get in there, but Brennan Poole did a nice job of closing the door. Lost his bumper out of the deal.
And William Byron's thinking the same thing. He's like, man, I got to do everything I can do to get myself in position for the free pass. So that's why you're seeing the aggression out of these guys and the bumper hanging off the back of the 48.
Elliott Sadler there as well. Good jump by Hemric in that outside lane, and his teammate Brendan Gaughan going with him. Blaney fast on the restart. So is Suarez. Hemric not only racing for an opportunity to go for the cash, he could win the stage, get a playoff point. He's one lap away from doing it. Gaughan settles in behind him. Cook has dropped back. It appears it will be Hemric and Gaughan that advance and run for the cash. Off of turn four, back to the line. Hemric going to win stage two. He's dash for cash eligible. He's a stage winner. He gets 10 regular season points, a playoff point. I would say that all worked out pretty good for the kid out of Kannapolis.
Well, and I talked earlier about the gamble that this team took earlier. They've done it all day long. Also, guys like Brendan Gaughan, he's going to be racing for $100,000. We talked at the beginning of the race how Gaughan has struggled all year. Bristol seems to set him free.
Fifth caution of the day out here at Bristol Motor Speedway. Ray Black Jr. had problems coming off of turn four. David Starr trying to avoid him, clipped the front end, and that's why you see all the fluid on the racetrack. Pop the radiator there. So 79 laps remaining. Kyle Larson leading. Ryan Blaney, Daniel Suarez, Eric Jones, Justin Allgaier continue to be the top five. And here's the reason for the caution.
Yeah, it looks like just a classic example of just getting loose on entry, and it just never grabbed for him, and he was able to not able to save it. It's just a fine line up there. You know, there's like I said earlier, there's crumbs up there, and the higher you go, if it's clean, it's going to be faster. But when you get that much out of the groove, it gets loose like that, and you just can't save it.
Hey, Michael, you had a good view of that, I assume, up on the spotter stand?
Yeah, I know. As a Starr came off turn four, really nothing you can do there. He was committed to try to get to the bottom of Black Jr., and he just can't turn on a dime like that. He clipped the front of that car, so looked like a little contact maybe back in the middle of the corner to Ray Black Jr.'s car, and away he went.
Make a mistake there. He got too high, and that was really a blessing in disguise for the 42 car.
Problems for Brendan Gaughan in the 62.
Yeah, he just got you.
One of the four drivers eligible for the dash for cash. Pretty good damage on the right front, it looks like, for Gaughan out of Las Vegas, Nevada. He was running 12th, sixth caution of the day, 56 laps to go. We understand there might have been some contact with the six of Darrell Wallace Jr. and the 62 of Brendan Gaughan there.
I was tight there off the gas. That was not intentional at all.
This place is not forgiving, is it?
Well, I think this same car will probably, you know, tell the tale here. And you hear Darrell lift out of the gas right there. And what happens, you know, you're committed to the throttle, and if the front end takes off like that, you wind up just getting into the car on the outside of you by misjudging just a little bit. I actually did that to Denny Hamlin a few years ago. The front tires just take off, and you wind up making
the
mistake.
Finish at Bristol.
I like where Hemric is, Adam. He's on that outside. You can see him making progress. He's by Allgaier. He's up beside the double zero. That outside lane is just working. Oh,
there goes Brandon Jones into Custer. They stay off the wall and continue on. No caution yet, but Custer goes way back there.
Bubba,
and there's the caution. Big hit. Garrett Smithley into Wallace.
Bubba got spun around, slowing down back there in traffic. And when you spin your tires like that, trying to stay off the wall, puts up a smoke screen. And there's no way the zero car of Smithley knew what lied ahead. Over on the back straightaway, watch Larson on the outside of Brandon Jones. And Brandon goes up the hill a little bit, and that turns him into Cole Custer. And then just checking up, chain reaction behind it, Kevin.
Yeah, and I think the 33 actually thought that the 42 might have been letting up, and he just caught the back bumper of that 33 by just a little bit and wound up crashing.
Good sportsmanship there.
Yeah, Bubba and Brendan like racing together, and Brendan certainly knew there was nothing intentional there by Bubba, and now Bubba's out of the race as well.
Let's see what happened behind him.
Followed you, still there.
Riding with Wallace here.
Keep going.
You see all that smoke? There's no way Smithley could see through that. His spotter trying to guide him through it as best he could.
Well, yeah. And Darrell had it beat down low. He got hit from behind. If he doesn't get hit from behind, he's going to drive below all that. Would have been the first car one lap down, would have been back on the lead lap.
Yeah, and the further back that accordion goes, the worse it gets, because it just keeps getting worse the further back it piles up.
Let's go back to where it started with Cole Custer. He and Brandon Jones got together. Significant damage, it looked like, on the right front for the double zero. No doubt they are going to have to pit here. Could really hurt their chances when you talk about going after that dash for cash money. There you see the
now
damage.
He's better than Hemric, and they're both keeping pace with Blaney.
Caution's out.
Caution for Ross Chastain.
Did we mention that things seem to pick up at the end for action with these guys? start also, trying to take more than they're willing to give.
I also don't know how he got in the wall, but under the red flag earlier, he and Jeremy Clements had a disagreement. Perhaps that could have factored in. Don't know that, but they did have problems early.
Well, cautions certainly breeding cautions here. I know you had a chance to look at the replay, Bubba. What's your take on what happened?
I didn't look at who spun there in front of us. We were fighting hard all day for the lucky dog spot, and thought I had it, and then I got run over from behind and got it back gathered up, and ARCA wreck happened there. So I feel like I was down there, kind of out of the way. I knew I threw up some smoke, but just unfortunate. You know, just how our day was going. We were stuck a lap down. I ran over a couple people. I still feel so bad for running or wrecking Brandon there. Definitely didn't want to do that. Just hats off to my guys for bringing a good Lidos Mustang. It's the best one we've had here at Bristol, so that's definitely an improvement. And pat on the back. But circumstances put us to the rear at the start, and I gotta say that put us in the hole, but it kind of did, and we were clawing our way back out, trying to make the most of it, using the chrome horn a little bit. But I really wanted sixth place today and didn't get that. But we'll go on to Richmond and swing for the fences. You know, we got three races left to seal this deal for the rest of the season. So nothing to hang our heads about. We had a good day.
Looks like there's a smoking right front tire. Great job by Quinn Hauf to get to the bottom, preserving that top 10 run he's having today, but unfortunate for Ross Chastain.
Halfback 21.
That's the chrome horn there, a little tap saying I was there. Oh, he's gonna hit him.
Contact, there goes Blaney up the track. Jones is by, Hemric goes by. Suarez and Ty Dillon follow.
Well, and Blaney was being very aggressive right there, guarding that position, doing what he had to do to try to put himself and keep himself in position to win this race.
We're like, do not cut me off or you will get hit. Looked like maybe Eric was on the brakes trying to stay off of Blaney, slid into him.
Yeah, I definitely missed that one. That was definitely the 20 sliding that left front tire and getting up into him, like Michael said.
This battle for second is getting really good.
Outside. Clear. Turn
caution
four.
Is out.
Down. Back it down. Back it down. Turn four.
William Byron, the rookie, started 19th, worked his way into the top 10.
I think he was racing inside of, and maybe not. Byron had been down inside of Justin Allgaier a couple of times late in the going.
Teammates there.
That's not going to be a good meeting on Monday.
You've had a few of those, haven't you, Kevin?
Oh, yeah. But it's hard here at Bristol because, you know, the 7 is thinking that the 9 is going to cut him some slack, and the 9's thinking, oh, I've got the 7 in a spot where I can make up a position. And then you have teammates hit each other.
And they had been racing like that for the last few laps. William had been down looking inside of Justin, and you can see there just a classic case of two guys committed to the same piece of real estate.
Hey, now on that last caution, Kyle Larson was was penalized, put to the back of the field. He's driven up to the top 10.
Stay low. Keep coming low. Keep coming low. Here. Go high. Keep coming. Caution's out.
That means he's going to start fifth on the outside. He could make it exciting for sure.
I think so.
Will Blaney bumping back?
You're darn right he will, because he's driving mad right now.
White flag is in the air. One lap to go. Sponsored by Credit One Bank.
And maybe Eric Jones is driving scared.
Clear by two. Keep getting it.
Six races in 2017. We hadn't had a repeat winner until today. Back to back, Eric Jones, a winner at Bristol Motor Speedway.
Now, my man, that is a way to make up for a mistake. Good grief. Great job. You and Rick both. Thank you, team. Appreciate it a lot. Appreciate everybody's effort. That was awesome. Thank you.
Speeding penalty back to the back of the field, but he was able to recover from that. That's a great job by the team, giving him the car he needed.
But you were right on the adjustments.
Yeah, the adjustments look good. I thought he ruined my good story, though. But
turned out to be a better story.
Better story from the back.
Hey, and Kyle Larson, who knows? If we had gone to overtime, he worked his way to seventh. He may have been able to make something happen.
Well, give a shout out to Elliott Sadler, too, our point leader.
Daniel getting married in the offseason to Kenzie Ruston. That $100,000 is going to help him out, you think?
And we can buy a lot of tires for the race car.
Yes. Spoken like a true driver. Here's how they finished today. Problems for Cole Custer and Brendan Gaughan on our final stage. Allgaier got turned around late. And Daniel Hemric finishes fifth and wins the $100,000. And winning the race is Eric Jones, Chris.
Eric Jones gets that win in Texas. backs it up with his second win here at Bristol. Eric, what a great drive there. You had that mistake mid-race. You had to go to the back. You worked your way back to the front. Talk about that one restart there with Ryan Blaney.
Yeah, we were, man, we were racing hard, and we ended up getting the lead and just held on to it from there. Finally got out front, got some clean air, and the racer scammer had enough to hang on to the end. So, you know, it's a day kind of a little bit like last year. Didn't really know if we had a winning car or not. And to come back from the pit road penalty like that, especially with not much green flag racing, was a lot of fun. It's a race I won't forget for a long time. And just thanks to Reesers, GameStop, Hisense, Interstate Batteries, Toyota, JGR, NASCAR, and the fans, of course. Just an awesome day for us.
Congratulations, Eric. Seventh different winner this year, Adam.
500 laps here, you just never know what's going to happen. But one thing we do know is going to happen, they're getting ready to drop that green flag, and boogity, 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 we're going to go racing on a Monday, boys.
Very orderly, no contact through one and two. Same for three and four.
Yeah, I don't see anything real weird happening. That extra substance they put on the track this morning doesn't seem to have affected it much at all. The guys are getting right to it without any problem.
Ouch. We are under caution at Bristol at lap 54. Kurt Busch, the first car to go around, not sure if he got tagged, but he had damage against the inside wall.
He ran the back of that 15 car. They were all slowing down for the wreck down there.
The 37 got in the back of him. I think he may have wheel hop trying to slow down. Oh, you see just a little bit of contact. Kurt Busch trying to get underneath Trevor Bayne, I believe that was, and the car comes around. While there's a lot of grip in the corners, not a lot of grip once you get off that traction strip. And then later, yeah, coming along later.
You see Kurt spinning.
Yeah, that's AJ Allmendinger.
Allmendinger goes by, back behind him.
And here's Kurt Busch.
I'm so sorry. I thought I was taking it so easy on it. That's my bad. We're probably all done.
Two. Now, watch as Kurt Busch's car starts to come around here and bounces off the inside wall. All the spotters are thinking right there that it's coming back up on the racetrack. And they tell all their drivers, jam on the brakes. He's going to slide back up. He doesn't get back up the racetrack, but everybody's all woed up.
Mike, in all due respect, you run so fast around here, even when the spotter tells you there's trouble, it's just hard, and Jeff knows this, it's just hard to get woed up, and especially if somebody's ahead of you like the 15 was, and now you see the car in front of you stopping, and you just can't stop.
Jamie?
And that was the first time in Chris Buescher's career that he's gone to a backup, and now his day is done, that second car. You just watched the replay. What did you see from within the car?
I guess I didn't realize there was I didn't know there was a wreck before that. You know, I know everybody was woeing up, and Kosh was out, and tried to get on the brakes, and they just wheel hopped. So just a pretty big shame. You know, our Busch's baked bean Chevrolet, you know, like I said, our backup start last, and we were rolling through there pretty good, and you know, we're fighting to be in the spot for the lucky dog there. You know, I know we were right there at it, and Ty was right there, and you know, we had found something after Larson passed me on the high side, kind of found something doing the same thing, and was just starting to pick up a little bit of momentum there. So I hate it. You know, I hate it for this team, how hard they've worked this whole weekend and on Monday for our race to be cut that short, and you know, I feel like a large part of that's on me. So gotta do better than that on my side, and we'll go to Richmond and see if we can go have a good day.
Same thing we saw Larson do in practice when he was trying that top groove.
But he is still the free pass car. Oh, unless.
Still right there. Austin Dillon.
Now it's Austin.
Well, Austin's going to fight back, though. This might help his brother Ty Dillon out.
And it does.
One of the hardest things to do right now. Larson behind you.
Oh, Larson backed off.
And so Austin Dillon stays on the lead lap, and his younger brother Ty is in the free pass position as we end stage one. Kyle Larson, your stage one winner over Truex, Jones, the teammates, Logano, and Johnson. Stage one of the books, it's all Larson.
Well, one thing
something we always know we're going to get at Bristol, and that's close quarter racing. Keep an eye on the 14 and the 6. Listen to Boyer's radio, not happy with Trevor Bayne.
Well, he's getting to repay that favor now. Now he's pinning him down on his door.
But it's not loosening up Trevor Bayne.
A little. I don't know. Give it time.
I think Boyer would like to get in behind him.
It was 2 years ago here at Bristol that we stood up to cancer and saluted our colleague and great friend Steve Burns. We lost him 2 years ago this weekend. So let's reflect on the life of a great colleague and a great friend, Steve Burns, as we crank it up.
Benedetta still holding his own.
Oh, gosh, he just about spun out.
Bottom, dig the bottom, dig the bottom.
He went into the corner. He got a little high, and the back end snapped around. Sorry, guys. I thought he was gone.
Man, you think these drivers aren't on the edge and working hard?
Why do you think Logano is so wanting to keep pressure on Larson right now? He figures he can force him into a mistake.
Oh, I see exactly what happened. He did. Larson did exactly what we've seen Ty Dillon do. He expected the 43 to go down low. He went up high and just got a little bit too high and about lost it. That was a heck of a save.
He's not going to give up the lead, I can tell you.
Kyle Busch, who finished 38th and 39th here last year, may have cut down a right front tire and then hit the wall in turn two. We're under caution. Turn number two. During this caution flag, Ryan Blaney has gone behind the wall with the hood
pretty tight.
Green flag.
Hey, car that's and a team has done a really nice job managing this race, and that's that 48 team. The 88 in the wall. Never made it.
Caution's out.
Wow, he hit that hard.
Let's listen in on Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s radio. He was running 20th.
We're smoking. Why? We just noticed when you left there's a little oil in the pit stall. Yeah.
Now that was before, just before the restart, was that radio.
They had to put some oil in that front tire, and he just lost the front going into turn one.
Yeah, it just goes up straight up the track.
Yeah, he's already in the wall. It had to be related to that. That's pretty odd. There's no real chance of that being a tire issue.
No,
just on the restart.
He went straight, so whatever it was, see right there.
That's definitely fluid underneath the right front, if I had to guess. That's a shame.
Junior finished second here last year.
Here he is right here, so let's watch him get off in the corner here. I think
you can see the smoke.
You see the smoke starts to boil out of the back, and the car just goes straight.
Yeah. He had no chance of making that first turn.
No.
his trail of some fluid as he leaves his pit, and I assume it hits the garage.
Let's do it now.
Vince?
Yeah, I'm with Junior now. I know, Junior, they were trying to address what damage was done before the incident and what damage was done after you hit the wall, but did you have any idea at all that there was a problem?
We come out of pits, and there's some oil in the pit stall. I noticed when I was getting lined up for double foul, it's smoking. I don't know why. But it's got oil all over the engine compartment. So I went in the corner, just went straight in the wall. But I don't know what's broke, but I think that's the end of the day.
Per NASCAR rules, you have to go to the medical center. Do you feel okay?
I feel good. We'll get in here and find out.
Mike.
Man, I can tell you that.
Eric Almirola, who got the free pass on the last caution. He's got a lot of smoke. In fact, I think the cockpit's probably filled with smoke. Yes,
yeah,
it is.
Sure it is. Now, is that something similar to what we saw happen with Dale Earnhardt Jr., or is that completely different?
He's come to the pit. One to go for Martin Truex. And they'll wave the stage flag after the 10th place car crosses the line. And who will that be? It looks like Stenhouse right now.
I tell you, I hope Stenhouse and Bain respect each other, because we know they have had a little issue, those teammates have.
Here comes Kenseth to the back bumper of Stenhouse. He's not going to get there. 9th and 10th.
No, but he was
two forwards.
Kenseth certainly was trying. You know, think of the start of the season he's had. He wanted one of those stage points.
Martin Truex gets his 5th stage win. He leads all drivers in that category. And we're halfway in Bristol.
With what their adjustments are, as well as air pressure.
All right, Michael McDowell and Corey LaJoie were battling for position, the 95 and the 83, and McDowell hooked him, and LaJoie got a piece of the wall.
Now that's going to be a tire rub with that right front if the 83 of LaJoie's not careful.
On the Wood Brothers 21.
Backstretch, one car around, Danica. Hard in the wall, and that is David Ragan.
And Danica up here, Mike, in the 10 car as well.
Some things just have a way of unfolding very predictably, and this was one of them. 6th caution of the day. Lap 323.
See what happened here, guys. I think we know, but take a look.
Danica on the bottom. Oh, David Ragan gets a big run, tries to go to the center. Make it 3 wide. Danica just didn't have any idea that he was going to do that. Comes up and makes contact.
Yeah, he was trying to go by his 34 car there and dove under him, and Danica was down below to make contact. Right here.
42, 19 and 11, stay easy, easy, easy. Back it down, back it down, back it down. Stay in the middle. You clear all the way back up, clear all the way back up.
Great
job.
That's
a really risky move to be making right there. I mean,
on his teammate.
I mean, I understand he had the run, and you know, he's going to try to dive inside him going into turn 3 as they went down the back straightaway. But you have to anticipate and understand with that car on the inside what knowledge they have, and Danica had no idea that was going to come and happen.
A lot of damage. Kyle Larson just barely squeezed through there.
Let's show you why we're under caution. This is the 2nd time for Kyle Busch today. He was 7th.
Watch this. Here he is right here coming into view. Watch this. When this thing blows, watch it blow part of that hood off.
Oh, man, that's a piece of the tire coming up there and popping that flat.
He's got 5 wins here, but in the last 5 races, he's had mechanical problems knock him out of 4 of them.
Yeah, unfortunately, he's seen that outside wall in the middle of the corner far too much lately here at Bristol. Yeah,
last time he won here, 2011.
And none of his own doing. You know, it's all been either right fronts or suspension issues. Did I mention how awesome Bristol is? This is awesome.
77, Eric
77
Jones.
In the wall.
Got in the wall in turn 3. And caution is out. 8th caution flag of the day.
Right side
Jones was in 8th place.
Got a lot of damage.
To both sides, right side's flat.
Uh-oh, got a little damage here on the 47. Almendinger.
It's a little more than a little.
Let's say when 2 cars have damage, they probably had some contact.
Well, let's see from Almendinger's viewpoint.
Oh, I think that the 77 of Eric Jones made contact with another car, cut his right front down, and he had a flat right front tire going into one.
Definitely had a flat.
Yeah, he and the 23 got together, and that right front went flat.
when AJ's close, almost made it.
Pit road is open. Lots of takers.
Larson, that's what I'm talking about.
Oh, trouble right here. Turn four.
Casey Kane, Darrell slowed way up, and Paul Menard had to spin. Had nowhere to go.
Just wonder if we don't have some kind of a loose wheel situation on the five car. He'd come down under that green.
Menard was in ninth place. Had a very good run going.
Menard right here.
Oh yeah. Oh maybe.
Oh yeah.
The
Kane
wall.
Is. Yeah, I see that.
If he had an issue and slowed down that much, or he just got in the wall and slowed up that much, but either way, Paul Menard had nowhere to go. You're carrying so much speed momentum here coming into the corner.
Let's see what happens.
One in the wall here, stay low, check up, wreckage, come back up, you're all right, top clear, yelled up.
Boy, you know, all I can think about right now is the mistakes that have happened on pit road between speeding on pit road, how it's cost two individuals a shot at maybe a win.
And the white flag waves. One lap to go, sponsored by Credit One Bank. Jimmy Johnson to the high side. He's going to come off turn four and win his 82nd Cup victory. Back to back again for Jimmy Johnson. Bowyer second, Harvick third, Kenseth and Logano the top five. Larson, Elliott, Truex, Stenhouse, and Denny Hamlin with worn out tires, the top 10.
Really good job, baby.
Look how excited Jimmy Johnson is. That's a big, big win. This has not been one of his best tracks.
Boy, just think about it. Last week in Texas, track conditions really treacherous. We start this race today, what's a track like? Treacherous. And he pulled it off.
Tony Stewart, the last time his number 14 car finished second was last July at New Hampshire. With Stewart at the wheel.
Category, this cat leads every category.
His last and only Bristol win was 7 years ago. Taking home the checkered flag, Jimmy Johnson. Today's Sunoco fueling victory. 15 cars finished on the lead lap in Thunder Valley. The race came a day late. Boy, was it worth it.
Yeah, the man that was chasing Jimmy Johnson to the finish line, and that's Clint Bowyer. How far have you come that you're a little frustrated as you climb out of the car with second place?
Yeah, I mean, you know, you got to put it in perspective. You're right. You know, we've come a long ways with this team. You know, Boog and all these guys, they work so hard. It's a fun group. Everybody at Haas, you know, Stuart Haas Racing. I mean, my teammates are awesome. It's so much fun to work with this group each and every week. You know, hell yeah, you want to be up there and win it. But the day we had, I got caught speeding on pit road, put us in the back. We bounced back. You know, the guys kept working on a car and got it better and better. Just appreciate this opportunity that Gene Haas and Tony Stewart gave me. You know, Mobile One, Haas Automation, everybody that's a part of that. You know, Rush Truck Center's Rusty. Damn it, about had one. You know, the Monster Energy, appreciate everything you guys do.
Clint Bowyer, second place, got a big hug from the team owner, Tony Stewart. Let's go to Jamie.
Well, Kyle Larson, he was the car to beat today. 203 laps led. You had a speeding penalty there. You start in the back and you end up finishing sixth. Kyle, what's your takeaway from today?
I don't know if we had the car to beat. I thought early on in the race, before all the rubber got laid down, we were really good. Middle part of the race, I didn't think we were very good. And then there at the end, I got the top going really good. So. And then I got that speeding penalty and set us back, and you know, we had to gamble there for that last stop and take two lefts, and we hadn't done that all day. And the balance honestly wasn't that bad with our Coda and Bank Chevy on two tires. So just four tires just had a little more grip around the bottom for a little bit longer than we did, and I had to get to the top early and was just following Kevin, hoping he'd make a mistake because I knew I couldn't go down the bottom and get by him. So. Had a kind of ride, but another good run for us, another top 10. Would have liked to have a top five, but a good points day for us, and we'll go on to Richmond, I think we're at next, and try and do better than we've done there in the past, and you know, extend on our point lead there.
We sure made it fun to watch. Let's go over to Vince.
With Joey Logano, fifth place today. You know, at the beginning of the day, we were all wondering what kind of race we were going to see. It was pretty crazy. How was it from your seat?
Crazy, to say the least. The Auto Trader Fusion had good speed if the track was really rubbered up on the long run. That's when we were our fastest. And caution at the end. That just the track cleans up, all these the hot tires pick up the rubber, and the race changed, and we didn't quite have the car as fast as it was when the track was rubbered in hard. So, you know, we scored some stage points. That's the first time we scored stage points in two stages in a race, so I'm proud of that. Man, I just thought we had position to win it if we can just take off better in a short run and then try to hold off that 48. That may have put us in position to win this thing, but just out of control for the first five, six laps and give up too many spots.
Well done. Joey Logano, fifth place. Let's go to victory lane with Matt Yoakum.
Took 7 years for his second Bristol win, but Jimmy Johnson takes another one in Thunder Valley. It seemed like you were the guy on that final run that found the bottom first and best.
Yeah, it was kind of interesting because when the 42 was there, it just created an environment to run the top, and I wasn't as good on the top. With the 42 not being up there in that first couple cars, you know, the bottom was really where it was at for the short run, and this Lowe's Chevrolet was flying. So happy to give everybody at A.O. Smith a good ride on the quarter panel this weekend. But we wouldn't be here without a ton of support from Valvoline, Gatorade, the fans, Lowe's, Chevrolet. This track's been difficult over the years, and we really hit on something Saturday afternoon in that last practice session to run the bottom. And it's honestly, it's what I've been looking for here for 16 years, and we finally figured it out. So I'm very, very happy. And I just want to give a shout out to Shani, Evie, and Lydia at home. I wish you girls were with me. I can't wait to see you soon.
When you scored your seventh championship, tying Richard Petty and Dale Earnhardt, you were so humbled about being included into their class. Now you're one win away from Hall of Famer Cale Yarborough, and two from Darrell Waltrip and Bobby Allison.
That's just mind-blowing. You know, I wouldn't be here without Mr. Hendrick's support. And just talk to you on the phone, boss. Thank you once again for believing in me. Jeff Gordon for believing in me. For Hendrick Motorsports to make this job kind of a family environment for all of us to thrive in. It's been a perfect environment for me, Chad Knaus. This consistent group of guys behind me through all these years has led to the environment to win 82 races or whatever it is, which is just insane. So truly humbled, excited to win back-to-back races, excited to win at Bristol, and I guess I'll be at Indy testing the next 2 days, and I'll show up in Richmond and try again.
Congratulations, Mike.
All right,
Jimmy Johnson's career, he's won one of every seven starts in the Cup Series. Here are your point standings. Kyle Larson retains the point lead. Chase Elliott second. Truex third. Logano, Keselowski teammates fourth and fifth. Jimmy Johnson there in sixth place.
His points are so important, Mike, just like what happened here. If we get qualifying rained out, you start the race by those points, and that's big. Has been for Kyle Larson.
So Hendrick Motorsports scores its 11th Bristol win, 247 Cup wins overall, beating Clint Bowyer by 1.2 seconds in Bristol.